Well, hello everybody and welcome to yet another exciting episode of JCPW, and we have got a huge card on the show tonight, including a qualification match for the title, and we will see the new women's champion in action as well. First, we are almost a week removed from lockdown, and in my opinion, one of the greatest pay-per-views that we've put out there. I loved it. Everyone, but we are going to be going straight into our opening match, which is a qualifying match to be involved in the Twitter poll for the Strong Style titles. As you see, making his way through the ring, this is William Zander. Now, William Zander, although him and his team did lose in the first round of the Heartbreaker tournament, there's something about William Zander that we like here. Who's out? Emma as well. Their fighting spirit, and they are here in JCW, and William Zander gets a chance to face off for his first title, but he's got a tough task ahead of him because he's taking on somebody who's been here for quite some time. And this is Hal Jackson. High speed Hal Jackson. For those who know Hal Jackson, he came here in towards the beginning of the last season, and he's had some high profile matches but just not able to get that final win, or that elusive win that will give him the chance to go to new heights. But like I said, this is going to be a four-way elimination match. As with all multi-man matches here in JCW, they are always competed under elimination rules, so if you get pinned or submit or tap out, you are eliminated. It's down to the last person standing. So is this the opportunity for Hal to finally get on the trajectory that he's been looking to get onto for so long? We'll just have to wait and see. Looking confident. Maybe this is his exit. This could be the breakthrough moment that he's been looking for so long. But he's got a tough task here. Not only has he got William Zander, he's got two other opponents, and your next opponent making their way down. In my opinion, probably the favourite for this match, and that is Blake Steele. Now, Blake Steele's girlfriend, Isabella Robertson, has seen success here in JCPW and probably will always be at the top end of the women's division here in JCPW. But Blake Steele is looking for that one thing. He's looking for that one win, that one elusive win that could propel him, as we call him, the Death Rider, let's call him. Again, he's got a tough task ahead of him considering the people he's in the ring with. It's interesting, if somebody like Blake Steele was to win this match, like, would he make the title a bit boring? Because the rules of it, this work, the way it works with these strong style titles is simple. Whoever holds that title decides what that title is. As Tom Doyle has done, he's turned the strong style title into, to be honest, it is an MMA title, so the only way you can win that title is by submission or knockout, and it is within the confines of a steel cage as well. You know, so they get full creative control over the belt. It'd be interesting to see what some of Blake Steele would do, but although Blake Steele is my favourite to win this one, here is a superstar who does seem to have so much to prove. You know, a superstar who's been here from the start. I will explain why they do have an open bar here tonight here in Minehead, and there he is, the original JCPW superstar. That is Vincent Lawrence, the Steampunk Prince. He is looking to get that elusive win. Again, another superstar who has had success here. I mean, this guy held the hardcore title, but he didn't hold it for that long, as the hardcore title was defended every single week, and it was an open challenge for anybody who wanted to challenge it for the hardcore title. And this could be an interesting one to see if Vincent Lawrence can hopefully get himself back in the title picture and see what he comes up with. Because this is the thing with Vincent Lawrence. Vincent Lawrence, although he did hold that hardcore title, he's not a hardcore wrestler. I mean, he stepped up to the challenge, but he's not a hardcore wrestler. He is a technical mastermind, this guy. So this will be interesting, as we see on the outside already. Blake Steele and William Zander already just catching eyes there, staring across each other there. This will be an interesting one. Like I said, the winner of this one will be put into the poll to decide who challenges for that JCPW Strong Style title. It's gonna be a great one, so hold on. And like I said, as you can tell, I can probably tell as well, I is just myself here, sound of commentary. Jason will be popping in for a match a little bit later on, but for the majority of the time, it's going to be myself. Jason had to sort some things out. Well, being on the management, he needs to do that. But here we go. The bell rings, and here we go with the opening match. As you see, the big men going for it, and the smaller men in the match going at each other as well. Like I did say, obviously, it's myself on commentary today, as Jason is backstage sorting out some bits and pieces for the future. As you see, William Zander with a Death Valley Driver. Really early on. Big move very early on for William Zander. And falls up the knee then. And then Hal Jackson throwing Vincent Lawrence to the outside. Like, as they say, Jayson Titus is backstage sorting out some business. You know, that is his job now. It is his role here in JCPW. He is on the hunt for talent. And, you know, he's been in chat. Tiger Suplex there. Just stop the train of thought. Tiger Suplex there from William Zander. But Jayson Titus will be popping to the commentary table for one of the matches. But the majority of the time, he will be backstage tonight. As you see, William Zander looking to take out Blake Steele with a beautiful cross face there. But it's not enough to keep him down. And then Blake Steele sending William Zander to the outside. Now in the ring, we have Vincent Lawrence taking on Hal Jackson. I see Vincent Lawrence with the sharpshooter. I mean, this is what I mentioned about Vincent Lawrence. This guy is he's a technical wizard. He loves submissions. He loves picking a body part apart. And can he do that? So that shot just laid out Hal Jackson there, but Jackson rolls to the outside. And then on the other side of the ring, we see William Zander and Blake Steele! Blake Steele! Black hole slam there on that steel grate on the end of the ramp. And Bullplex is in straight onto it. As you see, a combination strikes there, followed up with a clothesline there from Vincent Lawrence. This is a multi-man matching jump, so I will do my best to try and call as much action as I can. As you see, William Zander sending Blake Steele a little bit of a receipt into those steel steps. Now in the ring, we have Hal Jackson and William Zander. Made a mistake there for William Zander, taunting as Hal Jackson came in with the Revolution knee strike, and then it falls up with a straight knee strike to his face there, driving his face into his knee. What is William Zander going for? A snap suplex there from William Zander. And then on the outside, we see a look at this from William Zander. Death Valley Driver on the outside. Vincent Lawrence and Blake Steele still going at it. Oh, look at this Manhattan drop. Falls up with a big boot. Oh, that took his head off. It falls up with a big senton. No way, it's not going to be enough. There's one, two, three. Oh, Hal Jackson has been eliminated. Was not expecting that, especially from that move. That combination of moves made it fall up with the Death Valley Driver as well. As we head back in the ring, as William Zander, obviously Hal Jackson has now been eliminated, but look at William Zander, German suplex, holds it on with a bridge two. William Zander has been really impressive in this match right now. As we see him, up, oh, we're gonna go for the Kirifuda clutch. The Kirifuda clutch, Kirifuda drive, whatever you call it, cranking back on that chokehold. And he's done it, oh, he's done it. Whoa, William Zander. Two eliminations there. I did notice how Vincent Lawrence just stood off and allowed it to happen. Yes, I see that old school pile driver from Vincent Lawrence there to William Zander. William Zander's got two eliminations in this one. And both by as well, one by submission, one by pin. And there you see that overhead, bag suplex. William Zander is definitely feeling it. Be interesting to see something like William Zander would do with a title. Obviously, and brings Vincent Lawrence in the hard way with the overhead belly to belly suplex there. Has him up. Oh, what's this? Oh, unique move there. Not seen him do that. Not seen that kind of move before. I mean, almost like a drive to the knees, but then hits it up with a dragon suplex. Sorry, tiger suplex. Ladies and gentlemen, it is an open bar tonight, so excuse me for now. As he bullplex now, William Zander is tossing around Vincent Lawrence like a ragdoll right now. As him up with a snap suplex. Suplex City bitch, and that's a third, fourth style suplex. And there's the Death Valley Driver. A move that you see that William Zander's used that a lot in this show, in this match. But he's not gone and finished off. You've seen so many people, you know, win matches using that Death Valley Driver. You just get caught there by Vincent Lawrence. There's the veteran, is Vincent Lawrence there. Able to recover and is driving William Zander's face into the mat, and then follows up with a jawbreaker of his own. Goes in for the pin. Is that going to be enough of the jawbreaker? One, not even a two count there. Definitely not near, nowhere near enough to keep down. William Zander follows up with an STO. And again, there's the veteran instincts of something like Vincent Lawrence rolls to the outside. William Zander might have made the mistake of going out and joining him. As we see, look at the, oh, almost like a moonlight drive there. Flipping, twisting neck breaker there. Probably gets caught there. Kick to the inner leg, but again, Vincent Lawrence able to reverse. Gets caught with a huge short arm clothesline. William Zander does have that power advantage over his opponent. Slap there, and then a double Mongolian chop there to the shoulder blades of, sorry, to the shoulders, collarbone of his opponent. And then Vincent Lawrence driving his opponent in to that ring post. Obviously, there's no count outs, there's no disqualifications in this match, hence why the match is back in the ring. Look at what's this one? This is lost. Oh, what the GTR! GTR, is that enough? One, two. Oh, pleading with the referee, that was thought that might have been enough there. The lookout, Vincent Lawrence drops him down, straight DDT, back to basics there from Vincent Lawrence. He is looking for something. Oh, he's going to go for it. He's going to go for it. There it is. He has it locked in. The steam. That steampunk press, the steampunk last chancery, he's got it! Oh, he's got it! The last chancery has won the match. Vincent Lawrence walks away the winner, and he will go into the poll to decide one of the competitors for that JCPW. As it goes through the game, William Zander has so much involvement in this match. As if Vincent Lawrence will go on to be in the poll to decide if he can maybe get himself a shot at that JCPW Strong Style title. And the good thing without that Strong Style title, we've got the JCPW spot filled. And we look at this GTR, beautiful move there, right on the brick of the neck. But it wasn't enough. It was a close one, but it wasn't enough. But as I did say, you know, the JCPW spot has been filled by Vincent Lawrence. So if there's anybody out there in the world of core and virtual wrestling who wants a shot at that Tom Doyle title, a chance to create your own title in a sense, please hit us up here at JCPW, because we will be looking at entries. But there's the win Vincent Lawrence probably looking for quite some time. Ladies and gentlemen, that is a massive win for Vincent Lawrence. He goes into the poll. decide who will become the champion. But for now, we're going to take a short commercial break. We'll be right back right after this. And welcome back, everybody. And please go and check out GPW. But our next match, it is a big one. Could be a main event anywhere in the world. But we are going to have a champion versus champion match here, as we will see the strong style champion, Tom Doyle, taking on the current JCPW world champion. That is Taylor G. Taylor. As you see, Tom Doyle making his way out to the ring with his wife Yana Doyle there as well, which I suppose is a good thing, because wherever Taylor G. Taylor goes, destiny is not far behind. Like I said, Tom Doyle is in a situation where, you know, he's facing the JCPW world champion. Now, as we already said, it is just myself on the commentary tonight, and we do understand Jayson Titus' feelings towards said Taylor G. Taylor. There's no denying he's not a big fan of Taylor G. Taylor, but you know, the way he does things, the way he handles business, it is understandable. But, you know, is Tom Doyle going to be the one who's going to be able to shut him up? We'll just have to wait and see. I see Tom Doyle holding that lovely JCPW strong style title, but here comes the champion, the world champion, and obviously Destiny Reign was not far behind, as you can imagine. Mr. and Mrs. Hollywood, Taylor G. Taylor and Destiny Reign. Now, for those who did watch Lockdown, you probably have the same kind of feelings towards Taylor G. Taylor as Jayson would as well, because at the end of the day, although it was, in my opinion, yes, it was cowardly, but it was a tactic that worked. And look at now, he's still here, the JCPW World Champion, so you can't really say much. Yes, he popped in and out of the match, but, you know, that happens. Obviously, Destiny Reign has got to be thinking, so, you know, her losing her title on this, her winning the title, sorry, and then losing it straight away to Mercedes in that cash-in. And then obviously he was not successful in the rematch in that Lockdown cage match for that women's champion. Obviously Lazara, who came out on top with that title. But here we go, champion versus champion. Tom Doyle versus Taylor G. Taylor. The bell rings and we are straight into this one, as Tom Doyle there just letting Taylor G. Taylor know he means business. Look at those strikes. Something we saw so much in that match. It drops him down with a back suplex. Now, obviously, Tom Doyle is a superstar who claims to be the face of JCPW. As you see, Taylor G. Taylor with that reversal there, elbow to the knee. I'm going to follow that with, takes out the leg. Oh, we're going to see you earlier on. Panama Sunrise! Oh, goes to the pit of that Panama Sunrise. Not even a one count there. But as I was saying, Tom Doyle still has that grudge towards JCPW. It's a moonlight drive from Taylor G. Taylor, where he feels that he was robbed of the JCPW title, the JCPW world title. And Tom Doyle still claims to be the face of JCPW. But I think the person he is in the ring with right now would probably totally disagree with that. As we see now, Taylor G. Taylor on the outside. Big chop there to his opponent. But Tom Doyle looks like a roaring elbow, but gets caught. Nice to see both ladies standing back as a capture suplex there from Tom Doyle. I think Yana is just trying to maybe get a better look of what is happening. Kick to the midsection. Like I said, Tom Doyle needs, in a sense, does need to win this one to solidify his claim that he is JCPW, that he is the face of the company. As you see, Tom Doyle is throwing Taylor G. Taylor towards his girlfriend. Let me exchange a few words there with Yana. Look at this reversal. Obviously, for those who do follow JCPW, we do have a 20 count on the outside. Not usual 10 count. We are 20 counts. As you see, the guy Rito driven into the steel steps. Looks like these guys are going to utilize that 20 count. Up to 13, Taylor G. Taylor. Big kick there to the back. Took control after driving Tom Doyle into those steel steps. Up to 15, and Tom Doyle throwing Taylor G. Taylor back into the ring. Obviously, that's where the pin is going to come. Roaring elbow! Look to that area. Roaring elbow there from Tom Doyle, who gets reversed with a forearm of his own. Reversal, back and forth reversals between these two guys. Oh, and look at this. Oh, dude buster! Huge dude buster. Is that going to be enough? One. No, not enough. Taylor G. Taylor. Look at that kick there. That's what we're talking about. Tom Doyle falls up with a Kamen Goye! Huge knee strike. This could be it. It's one. Two. Not enough to keep Taylor G. Taylor down. Beautiful knee strike. As the Tom Doyle now going to utilize his striking advantage that he does have. Falls up with a Falcon Arrow. And as Chuck T would say, nobody kicks out the Falcon Arrow. But it doesn't go for the pin. This goes for those strikes again. Tom Doyle is now feeling it, the King of Scouse style, as he likes to call himself. Has his opponent draped over that rope. It drops him down with a neck breaker. Rope hand neck breaker there. Tom Doyle is looking in control, but just to say that, commentator's curse. As Taylor G. Taylor comes back, kick to the midsection. Oh, final cut out of nowhere! Final cut out of nowhere! There goes the pin. It's one, two, throw! Taylor G. Taylor! Catches Tom Doyle with a kick to the midsection and that beautiful final cut elevated DDT. As you go through the replays, see the amount of pins that we did see. Taylor G. Taylor trying to end this one. But look at this from Tom Doyle. Kamen Goye. Beautiful knee strike. But it wasn't enough to keep Taylor G. Taylor down. As you saw, the referee goes in for the count. But it wasn't enough to keep the world champion down. And it was a final cut out of nowhere. That does it for Taylor G. Taylor, and there is your winner, the JCPW World Champion, Taylor G. Taylor. Great match there, but obviously it looks like Tom Doyle still needs to do a lot to prove he is the face of this company. But we are going to move on to our next match really soon. But for now, we're going to take another short commercial break. We'll be right back, right after this. And welcome back to JCPW. You just saw Taylor G. Taylor picking up quite an impressive victory there over Tom Doyle. And I mean, I know you're not happy, Jason, but...
Saying that happy is an understatement, but you know, we're not going to live in the past, ladies and gentlemen. And tonight, we actually, I actually want to inform you all, we have an impressive debut tonight. But right now, we have Alina Valentina available tonight. She just came off of a sad, unfortunate loss from lockdown.
It wasn't an unfortunate loss, but let's not deny, she was very impressive in that match. And thing is, though, no, we talked about what happened with Vincent Lawrence earlier, you know, resistance, you know, brings reward. And this is a perfect example of it right here. Alina Valentina came in, I say this every time because I'm so proud of this young lady. I mean, she came into JCPW, not really knowing her character, not really knowing what she's about, and she's just transformed into this. And I mean, there's no denying that Alina was impressive in that match. I mean, she almost won it.
I did, you know, every woman was on the top of that cage, and it seemed like Alina was actually mere seconds away from closing the victory, but it seemed as though, you know, fate just cashed in on her a little bit later. But, you know, here comes the actual women's champion. And
here comes the women's, the new women's champion, Lazara, who had a really impressive, you know, second match. Well, not even a match, her first match going into JCPW. And she comes out as the champion. And I'm looking forward to the lights that are out. Hang on. Was she not alone?
No.
What the hell?
Those, okay, that's interesting. Those are actually two of JCPW's newest signings. Seems like Lazara has gotten to them. I was planning on having one of them debuting a little bit later on today, but I guess Lazara got to them before I could. That is Blair Hendricks and Alina and Luna Lucifina. Those two are actually some of the. Those are actually two very hot free agents. They're actually well known for their tag division, for their actions together as a tag team, as well as what they can do in singles wise. But it seems like Lazara has found them and has inducted them into the freak show. This is surprising, ladies and gentlemen.
Well, yeah, I gotta be sure. I'm in the dark. So I know we talked about these two before. I know you want to bring them in. You wanted to debut them here in JCPW, but did you expect them to come out with Lazara?
I did not. This is completely.
Look at that face paints. All Lazara. And there. So who's who? Which superstar? Who's Blair? Who's Luna? Which is which?
Okay, you might not notice, but the person in that black cloak right there with the mask, that is actually Blair Hendricks. The person on the other side in the blue gear right there, that is actually Luna Lucifina. Those two are quite big deals, actually. And the fact that Lazara was able to get to them, I'm a little bit worried.
Oh, we've got to see Alina. This is a huge opportunity for Alina Valentina as they both lock up. And Alina is going to use that wrestling background. And she goes straight into a nice little side headlock there. No, we all know what to expect from something like from Lazara. We saw the devastation she caused just in a short time. But what can we expect from, if you want to say it, team? What can we expect from Luna and Blair?
That's the thing. You can't expect anything. Expect the unexpected. That's all the advice I'm going to give to you. But right now, it seems as though Alina is getting the advantage over Lazara right now. But a little bit surprising from the person from Alina, given the fact that she's not currently in contention, but whoa, okay, actually, as I said, that Lazara right now is gaining the advantage.
Snap suplex there, snaps over a nice little suplex, and now Lazara strikes off her own, and huge forearm falls up with a backcracker. And the thing is, we know a lot about Alina, we know her heart, we know her drive, but there's not a lot known about somebody like a Lazara who just almost like just transported. This is what I was worried about. This is what I'm worried about.
God, nowhere to run. Alina's got her. Alina throwing him into. Oh god, Blair I mean, Luna right now distracting Alina as Lazara gets up.
What the hell is she doing there? Why? I mean, just give her a free exotic dance or something again.
Getting in the way, allowing Lazara to get up, and oh, it seems as though Alina. Alina's a little. I think Alina. I can see a little bit of frustration with Alina right now. Oh Christ!
They kick the face there, and now Alina is in control. Has the leg of her opponent cranking back on that one. This is what we expect from. This is what we expect from Alina. That ground-based, you know, ground-based style. And also, you know, he winning this one puts this straight back in contention for a shot at that title.
Yeah, most definitely very interesting given all it was. Oh, crashed forearm, running forearm. Oh, Alina with a kick.
Alina still with a little bit of a playing a little bit of possum there, able to come back there with a big knee to the face. As you know, Alina is going to use the strength that she does have. I mean, you know.
Lazara currently in control right now. Alina in the corner. What's she doing up there? About to take her up for the ride, it seems as though. But whoa, what's this?
As oh, all butterflies in the arms. She's got a butterfly in the arms. And with a butterfly, threw it halfway across the ring.
Wow. Jesus. What even? I don't even know what to say, ladies and gentlemen. The strength of the Lazara. This is. Oh my god.
Lazara, she's not see again. The thing is, this is we've not really seen Lazara wrestle, and no, we saw her in that match, and obviously that lockdown cage match for the title. I've seen his little snake eyes there. You know, it's not a wrestling match. That's not a wrestling match. That's just a taste of beat your opponent up so they can't get back out when you skip the cage. But we're seeing. I'm guessing Lazara definitely has a big power advantage. Maybe a power advantage that we didn't realize. It's an Aline there taking some books out of Tom Dolls with the strikes.
Mm-hmm. And right now she seems to be taking her down with some actual good wrestling combinations right there. And right now she has her arm hooked in. Right now Luna Lucifina is looking on and shot. Oh no no no. Oh god, was our managing to get.
Pulls out there, had her in that Kimura lock, but able to escape. And again, there's the strength of Lazara just picking, deadlifting her opponent, just driving her through the mat, and goes in for the pin. This is going to be enough. One. No, couldn't even get a two count there.
And here we go. Alina is going back at it, but once again, Lazara has her own.
No!
What even was that move? I'm not even sure what to call that.
That almost like a Uranagi, but a slingshot Uranagi. As oh, see Alina there floats in for the pin. One, two. That's gonna be close. Two. One again. The leverage. It's gonna get the leverage on this one. That's a combination of pins there from both ladies, and then falls up with an air dramatic. Alina stepped up recently. I don't know what it is, but Alina has really stepped up, and it's a perfect example. Look at this, cranking back on that beautiful crossface.
Cross, that beautiful arm trap crossface right now, but Lazara is not giving up. Seems as though Alina's got other plans in mind. Seems as though with that resilience of Lazara was not going. Oh god, and Alina showcasing some strength of her own, lifting up Lazara. Just going with those torso shots. Jesus Christ.
Straight shots. Going to wind your opponent. Going to slow your opponent down. Especially just straight shots to the midsection of your opponent. And Alina now going in but gets reversed. This little judo hip toss there from Lazara. Just sends Alina Vantia straight back down.
It picks her up again and yet again. That just plain out just using her strength to overweigh and overpower Alina, and oh my god, again Lair and Luna seems like Lazara hastily getting back inside trying to avoid.
I gotta get down and see Alina, nice little spine busted. I'm going to, oh, and Lazara just pops back up into a Koji clutch, old school wrestling move there.
Crushed. Oh, but Alina getting out fortunately. No, seems like Lazara might be in trouble. And oh, she's got the leg. She's twisting about, using in that wrestling ability, that absolute great technical ability, and just knees to the side. Lazara is in trouble.
I still drives the knees right to the midsection there, and like I said, Lazara looks like she's in trouble, struggling to get to the top there, using the ropes to get that. Gotta be one thing I'm quite surprised, there hasn't been a lot of involvement, apart from that little bit of earlier with Luna, there has been a lot of involvement from Blair and Luna in this match, which, you know, I'm happy with that right now.
Oh, very much so. You definitely don't want too much involvement from those two. This early in Lazaro's reign. Right now, these two are just having a good clinic right now. The feet, hands are on their feet, and Luna is just stomping outward.
Just laying their big knee to the face there. She's going to utilize those strikes. I mean, this match has been really back and forth right now. As she again locks in for that beautiful Kimura lock. Now we've seen the damage that somebody like Brock Lesnar can do with this move. I mean, he's broken people's arms with this.
And right now, Lazara doesn't know where to go. Oh, right now, Lazara actually fighting out, though. Lazara again fighting out of that Kimura.
But it looks like she's clutching that arm there. But oh, we see it. There's that people lifting up. She hit that move on Mercedes. 1, 2, 3. Again, there is the winner. Again, that knees, that move out of nowhere. Two surprise finishers to pick up the victory there. But again, Alina Valentina, great showing, but falls short. I mean, when will she get a break?
No, don't know. I guess right now this is just wrong place, wrong time. As Lazara just showcasing why she is, in fact, the women's champion. And I guess with a little bit of...
Say a little bit, it wasn't mad, there's a little less help than I was expecting. If I'm honest, I thought there'd be a lot more involvement, but you know, it seems that Finkel does have his freaks. Yeah, he comes down the ring, but we don't seem to get involved. He has his freaks well trained, you know, not to get involved unless they need to.
Right now they have just taken over the ring, Luna, Blair, and Lazara right now. Just these three women.
And there we go there, the freak show there, standing tall, still the freak, not always the freak show reign, here in the men's division. We are now here in the women's division as well. But ladies and gentlemen, we are going to take another short commercial break. We'll be right back for our main event. So get those drinks and I will see you right after our main event.
Trip. It's getting hard to breathe, take another breath. Murder on your screen, death is not a myth. The world is at my knees, not my fingertips. When it's start jumping on these blocks, have your heart pumping like Reeboks. Rally around your fam with 100 drummers. You looking at a savage, cover, cover.
And we are back, ladies and gentlemen. Unfortunately, Jayson has had to shoot off. He had to sort out a little bit of something. So it's going to be Jess, myself, for this main event. And we have a huge main event as we will see the freak show in action one more time. But they are taking on the tough task of JC Wolf's BK4 of Bad News Barnett and Lars Behrens. Nasty. After JC Wolf had a great showing in that lockdown chamber match, unfortunately just fall short. But it's very rarely we get to see tag team action here in JCPW, and it is great to have some tag team match here. And like I said, ladies and gentlemen, the thing with JCPW, we are inclusive to all, and we are looking for tag teams. So if you're a tag team, or you know people who want to get involved in a tag team and you want to get involved with JCPW, please, 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 please feel free to drop us a message either here on YouTube or on our Twitter at JCPWrestling2K, and we'll bring you in because we want to build a tag division and we want to maybe bring in a tag title as well. But here we go, we used to see Bad News Barnett and Lars Behrens in the ring waiting for their opponents. And they've got a tough task ahead of them because they are taking on another two members of the Freak Show as again the lights go out here in the arena. There you have it, Chrome and Mortis representing the Freak Show. Now, this has been an ongoing battle, but now it seems to have spilled over not only into our women's division, but it's always spilled over into well, I would say a tag division. We haven't really got that at the moment, but you know, JC Wolf is obviously the leader of BK4, and he sent out more. For those who watched Lockdown, Draven, another member of the Freak Show, and Mason Wolf had, in my opinion, one of the most brutal matches I have ever seen in the history of JCPW. And we've had some brutal matches, but that one was beyond brutal. I mean, we saw people going through the cage, and even that power bomb. Thing is, just to give you a little medical update on Mason Wolf. Obviously, you can see he's currently not here this week. He is back at home recovering, back in Newport, Wales, recovering after he took almost a career-ending power bomb off the top of the steel cage, right onto the steel railings that you see surrounding the ring. And for those who know wrestling, there's no give in those railings. There's no give in that steel fence. And he landed on that back first. Jeremy thought he could end his career, but he is currently on break, as well as his Draven, because Draven went through some big moves as well. But here we go. As you see, the big men of the teams going at it, Lars Behrens and Crom. As you see, Behrens now in control, has his opponent up and just tosses him over his shoulder with a big back body drop there. I know both superstars looking for. I know we see Behrens has his opponent up. There's a strength of Lars Behrens. I mean, this guy has unbelievable strength, kind of strength you don't get to see very often, and this drives his opponent there across the ring with a nice, almost like a choke toss there. But there's a reversal there from Chrome, who has a peel of his own, just sending Lars Behrens. And Lars Behrens is no small man, but he just tossed him halfway across the ring and then falls out with the backbreaker in for the pin. It goes, the pin is one. I'm not even gonna get a one count there. But all this war between the Freak Show and BK4 at one point has got to come to an end. And I mean, I think Freak Show are up on wins at the moment, as far as I am aware. As you see now, Behrens in the ring with Mortis. This is the faster guy of the team. Big nice little standing drop kick there from Mortis, but he gets caught there with a back body drop, just driven back of his head and neck and the shoulders right into the mat. They're driven down and then falls out with a nice, almost like a power slam there, inverted power slam, and a punch, straight punch to the face. Tags in his tag team partner. We've got the two speed guys, Bad News Barner, in there with Mortis. But look at Mortis, has him up and drops him down with a burning hammer. Huge burning hammer move there from Mortis, who now has control of Bad News Barnett. Bad News not realizing the side of the ring he was in, lays in a few elbows and able to escape, and now comes in. He's going to use that speed, and this is what I mean, springs off into a nice little springboard there into the Hurricane Rana. But Mortis almost gets a tag there to Chrome, but gets reversed. As you see, you're gonna see the first double team of the night. There's no denying these two guys. Oh, look at that, it's almost like a wasteland. Oh, into a senton. Nice combination there, speed and power. Wasteland there into a senton, and now Behrens in control. It's a straight punch and sends Mortis down to the mat. And then follows up with a big elbow drop and misses it. Oh, Mortis just sends Lars Behrens over the top. Now, this is the thing. Behrens and Barnett have been tagging for quite some time. I mean, they've taken on some great tag teams. You know, people like the Hooligans. They've taken on so many great tag teams around the globe, especially in GPW. But now we are trying to bring the tag team division here to JCPW. And as I did say, if you are interested in joining our tag division, because right now aerial division is pretty much full up, so we're not looking for other superstars. But as I did say, we will be happy to have tag teams. So if you and a friend are in a tag team, we've got tag teams interested, please come and see us, as you notice there with an old knee strike, but gets thrown straight back in the ring by the powerful Lars Behrens, who has him in a back body, a Saito suplex almost. Oh, that was a mistake there from Behrens, allowing Mortis to make the tag, but he tags in his own partner. Barnett now is in with Chrome, and oh, Chrome gets caught there, but shakes it off and just tosses the bad news Barnett across the ring there, and has him up on the shoulders for a power slam move. There we go, running power slam. Chrome is going to lay in the boots. He's going to try and do, he's going to use that power. But look at this. This would be a straw. Almost like the EBD claw there, but just tosses his opponent. Almost like a choke slam. But Barnett is able to get the reversal and use that speed to his advantage, drops the knee into the back of his opponent. And it seems now Chrome, Barnett looking to maybe get out some control there, but Chrome just throws him across the ring again, and an elbow to the top of the head. Thing is, Chrome is a you know, a thoroughbred. He is an old school wrestler. Ducks down, Pele kick, but oh, that didn't even shake Chrome there. Chrome just shook it off. Goes for it again, but oh no, but this time Chrome was ready for it. Drops his opponent down with, and this is what I mean, there's the strength, oh, just takes him down. Choke, almost like an STO, but keeps the grip and goozles him. Oh, what's Chrome looking for here? Has his opponent, oh, jackknife power bomb. Chrome is now in control, but just say that, the curse of the commentator. Barnett able to muster up some kind of strength to maybe get the reversal. Are we seeing him, he likes to hit a cutter. Are we going to see that Miller rope cutter from bad news Barnett? Are we going to see it? Comes in, there is the middle rope cutter from the middle rope. Beautiful move. Is that going to be enough? Because the pin is 1, 2. Oh, Chrome just gets the shoulders up there. But again, great, oh! Pulls the referee in the way and just pops him down. And another cutter from bad news Barnett. Goes to the third, but this time gets reversed. There's the power of Chrome, just deadlifts military press there. As the referee suddenly gets to his feet, just enough time for the pin 1. Not even a 2 count there. Barnett showing some resiliency as he goes for a knife edge, but he drives him down with all like a snapping. And again, another Barnett using a lot of cutters. That's a side of Barnett I've not seen before. Has him up. Oh, release German suplex. But again, bad news Barnett able to reverse and uses the speed there into a Hurricanrana. This time he makes the tag to his partner. Behrens is now back in the ring. Oh, Behrens is going to go for that spear. He is, no, he's not spear, he's going to go for that twisting big boot. That big Behrens boot! Huge spiral big boot. Is that going to be enough again? 1, 2. But Mortis is just able to break it up. As we've seen out, oh, Chrome, they're able to get the upper hand. This follows up with a big forearm. And another one. Bouncing off the ropes, going for a clothesline, and follows it with a bulldog. Nice combination to comeback strikes there from Chrome. Is it going to be enough? 1, 2. Again, Barnett able there to break it up. And Chrome just laying in the fists there, piling them on. Great match we are seeing here. And there's a reversal from Lars Behrens, who follows that up. Whoa, I thought it before, almost like an Irish whip, but Chrome was able to reverse it and into his corner. Oh, look at the power of Chrome, able to pick his opponent up, and we saw it, oh, almost like a Big move there. Oh, look, look at Mortis allowing the tag. He wants Barnett. But Barnett comes in. Now Barnett has control. This is the strength that you don't realize that Barnett has. Gut wrench. Deadlift gut wrench power bomb there. And Barnett is feeling it now. Has Mortis on the floor. A little bit of trash talking while he allows Mortis to get to his feet. Big mistake. That could have been a mistake there from Barnett. Has opponent up. Are we going to see here? Oh, nice! New move there. Almost like a gut buster. It's one, two. But again, broken up there. Chrome able to break up the pin there from Barnett. Who again goes to that driving cut. Oh! Unfortunately, Jason's not here to do it. Bang on himself. We've got a bleeder. I see Barnett as a point. Oh, he's going to go for that. Yo, sack a DDT. The bad news DDT. Is that going to be enough? One, two, three. He's done it. Oh! BK4 pick up the huge victory. The bad news DDT. And BK4 are able to pick up the victory. Oh, I think this makes things interesting because I think right now scores are tied. I think Freak Show are up on two or three wins, but so are BK4, especially with this win from BK4. But again, a great match and a great clinic in a tag team wrestling. But as I did say, if you are interested in getting involved with our tag team division, please let us know. Listen up. Bad news DDT. And that was enough to keep the Freak, to keep Mortis down. Admittedly, Mortis did go through that cage, that lockdown elimination chamber match. And there is the win. Your winners is BK4. Ladies and gentlemen, that was your main event. That was the final match of the evening. We hope you have enjoyed the show. And as I say, if you are interested in getting involved with JCPW, please feel free to let us know. But for now, gentlemen, we are going to go and we will be back next week with another exciting episode of JCPW. But do not forget, hopefully you've enjoyed the show. Please hit the subscribe button, put those notification bells on so you know exactly when we are uploading any kind of shows. And we might be bringing some internet shows. But from myself and Jayson Titus, we'll see you all on the next episode. Good night, everybody.